Welcome back, everybody, to Factoria. I am Eddie Man, and let's continue where we left off. In the previous episode, we pretty much started with our starting location and with mining a few items. We got a burner miner drill up for iron, and we got a burner miner drill up for coal. Let's go ahead and automate a few more other things so we can go ahead and get these miners automatically fed with coal and get copper online. Okay, alright, so let's go ahead and pull up some coal for there. And if you press right mouse, you can grab half a stack. So since we're going to be collecting a ton of wood, I guess I can use both wood and coal right now to fuel my burner miner drills. So how's everybody doing today? I'm great. Here in the sunny South Florida. It's been celebrated the holiday yesterday, 4th of July. Went to go see some fireworks. It's pretty cool. I had a lot of fun. Let's go ahead and grab this iron here. I'm gonna need lots and lots of iron. Lots and lots of iron. Alright, I'm gonna go back and grab some more stone. Stone is kind of far away. I'm gonna need to also clear out this forest. Maybe I should start doing that. Create a walkable path. Though I need to collect stone to make a walkable path. All things come, all things go. We'll get there. I chop these wonderful trees down. Now trees also, they eat up the pollution as well. So you don't want to chop every single tree down, because then the pollution are spread out more. And the biters don't like the pollution. They eat up the pollution and they make them evolve faster. So, alright, so we got a little path forming here. Set of stone. Let's just get some more of these further south ones out of the way, so I can see where I'm going. Okay. I think I'm gonna plop down a burner miner drill. Oh, I accidentally made two of them. That's no problem. And iron chest here. We'll go ahead and throw those in. And now come back for that. Now that's in a forest, so that shouldn't generate a lot of pollution. The trees should eat that up. Alright. As I said in the previous episode, everything is slow going at the beginning. But eventually we'll get the ball rolling here and we'll get this going. Let's see. Can I build? No, I need more stone before I can do anything. In that manner. Alright. Go ahead and put some more of that in there. And take a look at this here and see what that is. Let's just throw the rest in there. We're gonna eventually need it all anyway, so why not? Let's make another iron axe, because that one is gonna be gone soon. And let's create a more defined path to the stone, so I don't have to always run through trees to get to it. Now this might be where my stone furnace columns are. Because I have the coal here. Maybe starting here, work might go up. I have stone there. I can always bring the stone down and make stone bricks, because we need stone bricks on the belt on the bus now. These lime green patches are uranium. I've not personally have played with the uranium yet to build the nuclear power plants, but I look forward to that in the near future. On this let's play. Alright, so let's continue with the trees. The trees. Yep. We all, like I said, we all love the trees. Later on, we'll be able to build grenades and vehicles where we can run the trees down and blow the trees up. But not early game. We can't do that in early game. It'll take me a while to get back to the stone here. So let's go ahead and just run back, because I do want to get some things done before we run out of time today. Okay. 70 stone. Perfect. So we could build. I want one of those, and I want one of those. Okay. There is an achievement where you can have. You can have only up to 100, I believe it's 108 crafts in your pocket, which is the bottom right. The bottom left there is. Everything that's built there is crafting in your pocket. Now I've already achieved that in Steam, so I will not be showing that on camera. Unfortunately, I don't even believe I have that factory anymore. To get deleted that save. Let's head back towards the factory area. Well, it's gonna be known as the factory area. Collect that coal. And I want to build another furnace set up here for iron. And I want to get another coal going here. Got 50 in there. Let's top off this one. Oh, went to a little too far. Let's throw that in there, and let's throw 100 in for now. That one looks good to go. Okay, let's throw this in there, and this in there, so we get the iron plate going. Now, you don't need it. The iron ore, you can't do anything with ore unless you smelt it. For certain items, like coal and copper, you need to turn those into plates. For coal, you use that to burn in your miner drills and your stone furnaces, and later on in your steel furnaces. Coal is also used in the production of plastic. And in the new feature for 9.15, coal can also be turned into, I believe it's heavy oil, and coal for occasion process. I believe it's here in the technologies. If you scroll down, it's very advanced. Coal liquefaction. That's it. It takes a lot of science packs to make, but you turn 10 coal. Oh, it's 10 coal, 25 heavy oil, and 50 steam into oil production. So that's another good feature they added in the game. that's a long way from now, and that's another feature I've not played around with yet. So we'll see where that takes us. Let's go ahead and get copper online. Now copper setup is the same, but usually I do, for every two iron furnaces, I have one copper furnace. The ratio usually works out. So let's go ahead and build. Let's get the required items to build to get copper online. Now copper is either way to the left or right. Let's go over here to the right one. Stone, so it's out of our way. It also will give us 20 stone. Let's go ahead and get this one as well too. Alright, and of course there's more trees here, so we'll get rid of some of the trees. Sounds like a plan. Now, I've been thinking, I don't know if I want to do robots, logistic network, or should I just go with the basic building, everything on my own. You guys can go ahead and lay down some comments to see what you guys want to see. I'm open for either way. Probably going to go logistics coverage with the robots, but that's a little further down the line. Just gonna clear this whole little section out so I know where the copper ends. I did also play back my first video and I noticed the game volume was a little high, so I did turn that down a notch. If you want in the comments, also let me know if the volume is too high, the game sound effects. I believe I've leveled it out. This area is a little cleaned off. Let's just get rid of these two here. And there's two more over here we missed as well. Let's just knock that out. Alright, so we'll go ahead and we will build our first copper furnace. Copper stone furnace. I'm gonna do half of the iron coal in there and half of the coal in there. And that'll start making iron plates. Alright, we are on the roll here. Well, eventually I'm gonna get my science going. Maybe I should start digging towards that way. I need 10 bed science packs to start the first science, which is automation. Automation, first automation will give us an assembly machine and a long-handed inserter. Inserters, let's see if I can see an inserter yet. Yes, I see a burner inserter which feeds off coal, and an inserter requires power to make. It grabs an item from one section and moves it to the adjacent square. So, same thing with a burner inserter, but it doesn't require power, it requires coal. Or it could feed itself wood as well. A belt also requires iron to build, that's why I said previously we need tons and tons of iron. Tons and tons of iron. Also need to figure out where I'm going to set up my where we're gonna go ahead and set up our power. Power also needs water. I can go ahead back over by the stone maybe. There's a couple of lakes up there. Let's take a look at that. Let's get rid of some more of these trees so I can walk quicker up to the walk quicker up to the stone, and I can survey the area for power. Alright, there's tons of trees up here. Let's zoom in a little bit. I don't know if I want my power to be so far away. Well, it won't be far, it'll be close to what I built, but that's gonna be tons of trees I have to cut down. Tons and tons of trees. Let's go with that. Let's go ahead and fill you back up. Cause we need stone, lots of stone. Back to base. Gonna cut one tree. Ran out of my iron axe. Build another one. Oh, it was a log laying on the ground, so it caught me. Okay. Can't wait to start building steel so I can get a steel axe instead of an iron axe. It only takes half the time to. Alright, so let's go ahead and jump up out cold here for two more. And we'll set up do the four chain. Let's turn this one around. Let's get this one like that. So they're all gonna feed into each other. And the last one, there it goes. So then I could just grab coal out of each one of them for faster pick it up. Let's grab the iron. Alright, so it looks like I'm on the road to building my first steam engine column to get my power online. Again, we gotta find a place to put that. And it's got to be a place where we can expand later, because we're going to need lots and lots of power. Lots and lots of power. Alright, let's check the coal here. Let's top that off. Let's top this off. Okay. I think I can add one more to each at this point. Check the map to see if there's any red blobs yet. Nope, there is not. Okay, very good. Apologize for the screen flashing. My finger placement on the keyboard was not correct. Alright, let's go ahead and fill that up. So now we have two stone furnaces making copper plates. Perfect. Come back over here, grab some coal. And let's build another iron. Why not? Got tons of stone, let's go ahead and use it. Alright. And the coal we just picked up. Let's go ahead and burn a stack of 100. Now these are going to be running out soon. Oh, they're pretty decent. Iron out of all that. See, now I have a ton of iron, and not that much copper. That's good at the beginning, because we use tons and tons of iron. Let's go ahead and see if we can craft. Alright, so intermediate products, we can craft science packs. Let's go ahead and craft the first 10, because that's what we're going to need for our first technology to research. Let's go ahead and take a look at the copper again. I know it's dark and it's not good for YouTube, but eventually I will research lights and I will start placing lights everywhere. I don't want to use any mods if I don't have to in this first Let's Play. So we got a strict. We're gonna stick to strict vanilla. And it looks like I've run out of time for today. So, again, thank you for watching. And if you can, just quickly subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet. And also throw a like on the bottom of this video. It will greatly help my channel. And I'll see you guys next time. Thank you for watching. Bye now.